VASCOVID project is funded by the European Commission's Horizon 2020 program. Its main goal is to develop a device based on diffuse optics, which will enable the study of the endothelial and microvascular function in COVID-19 patients. About December 2019, we met a group of clinicians in Hospital Park Tauli near Barcelona, and one of them, Dr. Jaume Mesquida, described us how he uses near-infrared diffuse optics in the intensive care unit. So when the COVID lockdown started, my group couldn't go and do their work in the hospitals. So we started reading papers and doing brainstorming. One of my students, Marco Pagliasi, came up with the idea that acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS, that COVID-19 patients have, was measured previously by near-infrared diffuse optics. So we talked to Jaume and said, can we do something? Can we help COVID-19 patients with this? And he was very excited about it. So we started talking from home, mainly through teleconferences. And we started a project called HemoCOVID-19. And immediately we knew what was wrong. We couldn't buy the right device to do this work. So we knew that we had to develop a new device. And that's how VASCOVID was born.
We've already been working together in a brother project called the HemoCOVID project, testing the near-infrared spectroscopy in COVID-19 patients. And as results of the data we obtained from that, that's when the VASCOVID project arises. So we already have a lot of data on microcirculatory monitoring with near-infrared in COVID-19 patients. We just observed that we needed a better technology for doing that, and that's why the VASCOVID project was born.
The funding from European Commission is allowing us to do something unique that we cannot otherwise do, to bring industry, academia and clinics together, and even have a partner whose expertise is in the medical device regulations. This allows us to move our stuff from the benchtop, from our laboratory, to the clinic and to the market much faster in a much better coordinated manner. And what will it allow the doctors to do is to manage the patients according to their need, decide when to turn them to the prone position, so when their face is down, which is utilized in COVID, and also whether it's safe to take them off a ventilator when they are ready to leave the hospital. In the long run, there are drugs that people are developing that target to fix this endothelial function. But those drugs cannot be given to everybody, so this method will allow doctors to select who to give this drug to. So, long story short, it will allow personalized management and treatment of these patients.
One of the good things of that monitoring technology is that it's not invasive, which is sometimes the patient in the ICU will have to pay a price which is really, really high. One of the main ideas of the project is that the technology will help detecting the how ill is the microcirculation. We trust in the vaccines, but other than vaccines, people will get ill as well. If we use the target of the COVID-19 disease, which is the endothelium, the vascular, the microcirculation of the patient, if we can monitor that, we will be able to monitor the response to new treatments. We have two different informations, that the endothelial function and the oxygenation of the tissue. They complement themselves, but they are not the same.
By using lasers in different colors, looking at how they are absorbed by the tissue and how they are flickering, we are able to measure the amount of blood in the tissue, amount of oxygen in the tissue, and how blood is flowing. Principle behind the optical part of VASCOVID is that light in the near infrared, so light that looks reddish to our eyes and the part that we cannot actually see, can enter into someone's tissues, does what we call multiple scattering, it goes all over the place, and it gets absorbed by red blood cells, and can tell whether they have oxygen or not by shining this light in multiple colors. You see here optical fibers, just like the ones that brings internet to your home. In this particular case, we have these two fibers next to each other that deliver light to the tissue. As I said, this is laser light. You shine this into the muscle, And then about a centimeter and a half away with this other fiber, you detect the light that has gone through the tissue, interacted with the tissue and the blood, and came out. So then what we do is we attach this onto the muscle here. And then when we turn the device on, it quantifies how these lasers are, speckles are fluctuating. And these fluctuations tell us information about blood flow. And we can do it in real time, and we can do it safely, because the amount of light we deliver here is much less than the amount of light you get when you are in the Casteldefels beach on a sunny day. A very important milestone for the project, because at this point we have released the first prototype. This prototype, while it is not ready for being sold or getting a medical device approval, it has got all the bells and whistles in terms of the quality of the data it can take and most of the features necessary, such as the safety features, quality control features, that it will go into the ethical approvals to start the clinical observational studies. They will start in a few months.
So now we have a prototype that is ready to go to the clinics. In parallel, we have also developed the clinical protocols to test this device on both on COVID patients and on general ICU patients. And we've also done a lot of work on regulatory aspects, and this will be ongoing until the end of the project.
We also will have a set of data in our hand that will support both the safety and usability of this system, but also scientific information that tells whether we will be able to use it in the clinics to aid in the management of COVID-19 and other patients at the intensive care units.